And right here. Beautiful, right? How's that for an experience?
Yeah.
but you see, calm down. Hey, you know,
yeah.
it's where everyone's trying. Everyone's just they have animals.
Yeah. Almost up.
And so for me, just I would slow down your pace so that you can just zone in. I understand if you speed up through there, that's fine, it's normal.
Yeah.
But then catch it and cool back down. Because right now it's about regulating ourselves.
Yeah.
Not feeling like we gotta zip through everything, not rushing, being clear, knowing when we, it's that song, when to hold up, when to fold, when to, it's like a, man. You got to
know. So this is the song I was thinking about, but it wasn't coming to me all the way. Kenny Rogers, The Gambler. You should go check it out. Give it a listen to. It's a great song. And I believe there's been other people that have covered it. I even think Kenny Rogers covered the original artist.
This is where when a dog is lunging, barking, you pick up the pace. This makes sense.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But then we get to the safety zone.
Yeah.
And it's like, cool. Don't get caught in that event.
Yeah.
And it's very easy to do.
Yeah.
And then right now it can be easy to get caught in that higher level of adrenaline and the cortisol levels because it seems like it's like our mind is potential danger.
Yeah. Not again.
Right? Right?
Yeah.
And you're doing great. It's just, I would just think of this as a meditative exercise that you're trying to be as calm, cool, and collected as possible.
Yeah.
Only using what is necessary. The art of that is so difficult to do.
Yeah.
But think. What would he have been like in the past in a situation like this, right? Lunging.
Yeah.
And you cruised on by. You cruised on by and didn't have to do anything other than just walk.
Yeah.
But if he would have been starting out like he did, where he was out front in the parking lot, it could have been a different story.
For sure.
Because he didn't set a tone. This is all fine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so think of it like this, and this is all good, like, because this is the first time we've ever tried to do this together.
Yeah.
So I want you to think, like, right now, that you want him behind your heels.
Yeah.
Like, everything back here, cool. If you feel like you're getting pushed and he's kind of creeping and you just start to feel, sure, communicate, but...
Yeah.
Don't be so, hey, and keep moving. Hey.
Yeah.
Get the point across. Stay in there a minute. And then mosey on. I want you to just really feel the steps.
Yeah.
And not feel like you're like, hey. Because what we're really doing is forming a relationship. Excuse me. An understanding between us and the dog.
Mm-hmm.
That this is how we do this. And if we can be calm, cool, and collected, there's no big deal. Just this, I'm just letting you know. That's not how we do this.
Yeah.
And we don't want him in front because we could turn around this corner. There could be someone.
Yeah.
And he could feel threatened. And then he could bite.
Yeah.
And so we want to say, hey, you step back. I'll go into the line of fire.
Yeah.
I'll do it.
Yeah.
Right? And so then he can go, okay, I'll follow your lead.
Yeah.
Because I don't really want to do that job.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And look, he doesn't need to be told to sit.
No.
He doesn't need to be told anything.
Yeah.
He's like, all right, let me let me sit down because it seems like we're here just chatting.
Yeah.
He's not trying to go and wander off. Now he's going to lay down.
Yeah.
Right? And this is good because dogs that are super nervous,
circling frantic,
pacing all over the place, and then you get to the levels where they're not going to sit down. Yeah. They're not going to lay down.
Yeah.
They are like, no, I got to be ready to go.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And so the fact that he's doing this is awesome.
Yeah.
And this is why we slow down, because then we're taking in this environment. We're out in it.
Yeah.
But say we start to see a person.
Yeah.
I would recommend that then we start moving.
Yeah.
You know, we might be in a great conversation, but right now it's just saying, hey, let's just move.
Yeah.
Let's not really have people coming into our space like this when we're chilling. So then it's going to help you feel better. It gets that nervous system moving instead of, and then later we can build into people coming in and through while we're hanging out. But certain situations, you should say.
We're going to
move off.
Yeah.
I don't want to deal with this person or this type of dog or, right?
Yeah.
So it's beautiful. But just think right now, if you think about the first video, he was pretty much just like right here.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And that's cool.
Yeah.
Right now, it's just be behind.
Yeah.
Don't be aggressive. Right?
Yeah.
We don't need him to necessarily create so much of the stay far back. Now, if he's like stepping on the back of your feet, and, definitely say something to that.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah.
But if it's because, you know, something spooks him and he runs in the back of your leg, you might still address it.
Yeah.
It's not like some dogs will.
Yeah.
Hey, watch where you're going.
Yeah.
Right? But I'm just trying to give you an idea so that you hopefully have a clearer vision.
And I just always felt bad because, like, I walk slower, you know, for obvious reasons, because I'm not where I want to be. So I'm like, I just have a really slow walking gait and everything.
Yeah,
so.
And you should walk slower.
Yeah.
You should.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm saying, even over there, I said, slow down.
Yeah.
Like, you don't need to be so quick. I understand the situation, but then slow down.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just enjoy.
Yeah.
Okay? Like, it's not a race. It's not a competition to see how quickly we can get through.
Yeah.
It's not about trying to stay fast-paced to stay ahead of him.
Yeah.
He needs to be following our lead.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So this is why we should be able to stop. Be able to talk, we should be able to do all this, because what if we needed help and we're shopping?
Right, yeah.
Hey, so blah 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 blah. Mm-hmm. Right? They need to be able to deal with this.
Yeah.
Because we're preparing them for the life we live.
Yeah.
And I think he's doing wonderful. I just realized that
it's like not even shaking. I mean, he's like,
but where he was before we met to now.
Yeah.
Is amazing.
Different dog,
Different dog, right? And that's what we have to keep thinking of. We're on the right path.
Yeah.
On the right path.
Yeah.
But this is a relationship. And so he's trying to get to know me. He's trying to get to know the new you. He's trying to get to know this world. Like, there's a lot of going on.
Yeah.
And that's why it's just time and patience. It's like, in our life, we always want to speed things up. And it's like, sure.
Yeah.
But there's some things that just take time.
Yeah.
It's like I'm reading this book and they talk about personal development and like business strategies and saying, you know, you want to get to where it's faster, more efficient and all this.
Yeah.
But at the same time, all these little tactics and stuff he's talking about, he's saying, don't think you're going to get this overnight.
Yeah.
So it's like one concept is like efficiency and speed and, but at the same time, don't be thinking you're going to get all this and change and everything overnight. And like these things take time to then better your processes. And and there's also a limit on how certain things can move.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And then sometimes we can break those barriers that we thought was a limit.
Mm-hmm.
Like the 4-minute mile and that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna stop the how much time I have now. Cool. 36 minutes. Definitely have enough. I only had 10 minutes of record time. So when it comes to what I'm discussing, any questions making sense? Yeah. So I just want you to slow down your pace. I'm going to go ahead of you. Okay, I'm just gonna go a little ahead of you so that you have more ability to move and be more natural.
Yeah.
It's a little bit challenging when you're first working on things and building a relationship when there's someone else right beside you.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna go ahead because if anything, that would make him speed up. Versus if I'm behind, it might make him lag. Because he's like, wait, what are you doing back there?
Yeah.
Kind of thing.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna just be, you know, 5-10 feet ahead, not very far.
Yeah.
and then I might move around you, but the perimeter lap that we walked last time, that's what we're doing.
Cool.
So you know which way to go.
Yeah.
But so don't mind me. It's your pace. I might say, hey, slow down again.
Yeah.
Like, see what happens if you stop.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
But other than that, just do your thing. And see right there? And then move your body. And exactly. And so instead of relying so much on the stick, I want you to be thinking your body language, your energy, turning towards him. Hey, boom.
Yeah.
So it's kind of the build into that.
Yeah.
Not relying so much on the what you have in your hand.
Right, yeah.
Because ultimately, we want it to be our body language, how we're moving, what we communicate.
Right.
And it all starts from there.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
And then slow down the pace. It'll be harder because, like, since I'm ahead,
yeah,
it can make you start to feel like pick it up. So slow it down even more and see what happens when you stop now. Perfect. Awesome. Awesome. You can continue forward now. Nice. Yes. It's also a freeing experience when you know you don't have to have like a treat bag and
yeah,
remote caller and all these like things,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
It's like, cool. And these type of things, like move right through there and I want you to just move through and don't put it over. So like, just do this and then move forward. Yep, and then yep, wait right there. And move again, move forward. There we go.
Hey.
Yeah, you're good. Just
hey.
You wanna think where it's like if you walk, here, and if you're him, hey. You know?
Yeah.
Like, dude, like, don't be pushy. It's a lot of how you're showing up, the body language, the energy, how you move, more so than anything.
Yeah.
And then move forward, and then stop. Yeah. And so it's just like where you're just saying, you got to be paying attention to what I'm doing. Yeah. And you have this idea in your head that what I'm looking for is you stay behind me. Yeah. So then if I say, hey, and he stops, I keep moving forward. And then I might stop and then see how does he do, you know? So this is where you just move. Yep. And then you'll move right through here. Yes, thank you so much. And so everything is just, this is how we're doing it, kind of thing. And you have to have that image in your mind.
Yeah.
Or then you're not going to be consistent.
Yeah.
Then that becomes confusing.
Yeah.
What?
Sometimes the dumbest dog almost run into that pole.
Oh, yeah. Well, this is why, like, if you cater too much to him and, like, moving the lead, like, you want to just let... You got to let him start to figure out how to navigate this stuff.
Yeah.
You know? And we're taking the time in order for that to happen. Sure, do we got a lot of plant situation going on in here.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Look at how big these palms are.
They're like usually reasonably priced.
Yeah. Might have to. Oh, pineapples.
Nice ferns.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And
they're
a lot
of good fit. Yeah. Yeah, they're going all out.
Undercut those plant stores. Hey.
Just keep moving. Don't worry if you feel that tension and he's smelling, like, just right now we're just moving along, okay? You might let him start to smell and then you give more and more slack as you move away.
Yeah.
Okay? But it's all about him keeping up, kind of tracking us down versus us constantly, like, oh, you want to stop and smell this? Well, you want to go over there? You want to go do this? Right?
Safari.
Yeah. Like, I'll take the dog on those type of things versus the dog taking me on those type of things.
Yeah.
Well, the first lap, how does it feel?
Wasn't bad.
Yeah. I think right off the bat, that was awesome.
Little dogs, he doesn't like them. Yappy little things.
Yeah. But this is where we can see that he can navigate those things.
Yeah.
Doesn't need medication. Doesn't need to be isolated. Doesn't need to stay in the car when you go into Lowe's.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Life opens up. And then we get to see, after such a big journey, will he get into the back? Man, how did we go from 80 to snow, huh? Always looking for help, huh? I'll set this up for you. Yeah, I know. It's like right when we get out the ramp, he's like, all right, I'll jump in now.
Such a little... Come.
There he goes. Nice.
She's...
Who cares? If it takes getting out the ramp to get him in a
well, that's why I bought this, so.
Yeah. Awesome. Awesome.